The final type of optimization for reducing the miss rate that we will look at is a so-called loop interchange, which is one of the compiler optimizations that can be done to transform the code into code that has better locality. So suppose that we are initializing a matrix like this by having an outer loop and an inner loop, and then we initialize the element and then loop like this. The layout of this matrix in memory, if it's a C array, is such that it begins with A00, the next element in memory will be A01, and so on. Eventually we have the last element of this row, and only now we will have A1, 0, and so on. So now let's look at how this loop accesses these elements. I and J are both 0 at first, so we will access this element. Next, J will be incremented, so we will access this element, and then this element, and so on. We will access all of the rows of the matrix before we come back and start accessing the second element in each row. So the problem is, when this is accessed, we fetched an entire cache block worth of stuff into the cache just to use this one element. Then we're going to fetch a block here to use this one element. And by the time we reach the end of the matrix and loop back here, we might have run out of space in the cache, and the block that we would now use has been kicked out of the cache. So we fetch it again, use this one element, and so on. So we have one miss per access here. So a good compiler will detect that the order of these loops doesn't match the layout in memory, and it's going to perform what is called a loop interchange, which amounts to simply swapping the two loops. So now the inner loop is the one that moves to the next element in memory. So once we fetch a block from memory, we end up using the whole block. Only then we move to the next block, and so on. Once we are done with the row, we move on to the next row. So now we are nicely sequentially accessing this matrix. Not only does it improve locality, because now we end up accessing the entire cache block at a time, but also it makes the access nicely sequential, so one of the prefetchers can do a good job on it. So this works really well. It dramatically improves the hit rate that we're getting, but it is not always possible. You cannot just take any two nested loops and transform them this way. The compiler has to prove that this code and this code are equivalent, which it does by proving that there are no dependencies between iterations of these loops.